How is digitization changing both the design and operation of the buildings we work in, creating new levels of productivity and hyper-efficiency? With the COVID-19 pandemic testing the resiliency and agility of organizations across all sectors, will work as we know it ever be the same again? And as we enter this new era, what role will digital technology play in transforming our daily working lives?
The pandemic has accelerated these developments so that digitization helps them to increase their resilience, to increase the efficiency, and to increase their agility.
The pandemic is really bringing the case for change because the new ways of working into the future are going to be different. We are seeing that this being a catalyst in terms of how technology can come and make buildings smarter, the experience for the employee much richer and easier to navigate on a day-to-day basis.
Being able to use data and analytics insights to not only drive better efficiency, but also the more effective interactions between people, better collaboration, especially in the post-COVID world. It's even more important that we use the analytics and the insights to be able to create healthier and safer and more productive workplaces.
Across industries, the fourth industrial revolution has led to increased levels of automation, remote operation, and even predictive maintenance. So the question remains, how can business leaders embrace these new digital-enabled efficiencies while still maintaining a people-centric workplace? Digitization continues to change our working world, but the recent global pandemic has greatly accelerated our adoption of technology, helping us all to adapt to a new normal.
Our company has been very big in remote and working from home already. We will see still an increase in that respect, and that of course has impact also on the working space, on real estate and deployment.
We're going to move into a hybrid. And we're advising many companies on is to think about their portfolio in terms of the hub and the club.
Every organization needs to be clearer than ever what its values are. And so that you come into a place of work, you're going to get a shot of the values of that organization. The workplaces need to become a community center or even a cultural center.
The workplace of the future is less about raw accommodation of desks, and it's more about the quality of the interaction.
Creative energy and creative tension is something that you can't do on a Zoom call. You have to feel that energy and bounce those ideas off each other. Buildings, and particularly workplaces, will be much more focused on those moments. We need to make sure that we have the environment around us that means that we are, yes, productive, but also happy and we're looking after our well-being.
Many businesses are looking to the design of their offices to ensure productivity, but also to increase the well-being of their employees.
We've been spending a lot of time over the last half a decade working with Google on their future work environment. We ended up creating almost an archipelago of interconnected platforms, each platform seating 150 people roughly. Each of these platforms were touching the other platforms, gently shifting levels, so you could walk from one to the other, but the ocean separating them were courtyards, and there we put all the social functions. And then from each of those courtyards, you could ascend up to the more tranquil archipelago of collaborative interconnected platforms.
In recent years, a rapid adoption of innovative technology has reshaped the office, but technology has always been at the forefront of factories and industry. Today, trends in digitization are leading to vast increases in productivity and efficiency, continually transforming how these work environments operate.
New technology gives great opportunities to further digitize your complete operations. That allows you to simulate your site, it allows you to train your people remotely, it allows you to play different scenarios, and with that increase capital efficiency, human efficiency, and also resource efficiency.
Empowered with data, and much more importantly, empowered with insights that gives you what works well, what doesn't work so well, where there are opportunities and bottlenecks.
We ourselves run roughly 200 plans globally. One of the plans in Indonesia has been awarded by the World Economic Forum as one of their lighthouse factories.
One of the things that the World Economic Forum has done to help shine a light on success stories is that we built what we call a global lighthouse network. This is a group of factories implementing new technologies like the Internet of Things across the entire supply chain. And what we're able to do is help ensure that their best practices can reach a broader community, not only of big global companies, but also of small and medium-sized enterprises.
The Batam plant is a testbed for IoT-enabled solutions, and its synergy of AI, machine learning, predictive and digital maintenance, and augmented reality technology has empowered its workforce to deliver a 40% improvement in on-time delivery. The site has also seen a 44% reduction in machine downtime in 1 year alone. Such factories are paving the way for other organizations working towards their own digital transformation, becoming more efficient and sustainable.
Digitization helps them to take away tasks that an educated person does not need to do anymore. I give you a simple example. We allow our service technicians, when they're standing in front of a cabinet and need some support, they take their mobile phone, they hold the camera in front of the cabinet, and then a remote service technician can show them the schematics next to it, and then also what kind of tasks need to be done.
In new buildings, the fourth industrial revolution has seen a rise in efficiency and a drive towards sustainability goals. But retrofitting legacy buildings and industrial plants can be just as beneficial and more environmentally friendly.
The Internet of Things allows us to collect data from the ground floor, from a shop floor, from a plant, from a data center, from a building.
And all that data and information is now available to the facilities managers who are actually managing buildings. You can reduce your CO2 emissions and energy consumption by between 15 and 20%. And one of the benefits of sensor technology is actually it's a very cost-efficient solution.
And there are plenty of examples which will, you know, allow us to increase efficiency and produce more with the same resources. And it allows us to have much more capital efficiency because the machine can work at a longer period of time. We can run a predictive or prescriptive maintenance, meaning we know in advance what will happen and can make suggestions what to do that it will not happen. Every minute lost means a loss of production. It means also that your capital efficiency is going down. So with that, you can really reduce the amount of risk that you have in your facility.
Digital solutions have impacted all industries, and at Saint-Gobain, where they've been manufacturing material for buildings, transportation, and even the aerospace industry for the last 50 years, digital solutions like Schneider Electric's EcoStruxure have increased energy efficiency to such a degree that they're on track to cutting carbon emissions by 20% by 2025.
At Saint-Gobain, innovation is never more than 5 feet away from where you are, in a house, in an hospital, in transportation, and the most amazing is companies like NASA and SpaceX. At the site level, we use energy 24/7. We have to optimize cost and energy consumption at our sites, and we have to have the proper tool within the plants and the better experts to support us in this management. The strategic decision was made to outsource the service of procuring energy to Schneider Electric. Before we had no visibility, each plant was buying energy from their local utility. Thanks to the EcoStruxure, we have saved on a spend which is in hundreds of millions of dollars and fueled innovation at Saint-Gobain.
We can support our clients to increase efficiency, increase health and safety. So with that, get the best out of the assets that they have deployed. It is possible today to get a return on investment in less than a year. We can also drive down the utilization of energy by up to 50, 60% for the same task. I mean, these are humongous savings.
Smart energy systems are a critical piece to delivering the net zero carbon revolution we need in the built environment. They are bringing in the necessary optimization of systems, lighting, heating, cooling, that brings better information and disclosure, and of course, that people get empowered by the data that the systems offer.
But does all of this efficient technology come at a price? A recent World Economic Forum report forecasts that half of all work tasks will be handled by machines by 2025. Where will this leave the average worker?
By putting people right at the heart of the design and by using data and evidence and not guesswork, you can really push the buildings to be more efficient, more predictable, and actually be human-centered. So it drives the better health, well-being, and productivity of people.
I believe people will continue to be at the heart of the operations. Tasks and jobs have changed. We've had this in the third, the second, and the first industrial revolution as well. And usually it was for the better. And that's what we will drive for.
Most recently, the impact of the pandemic has seen a radical reevaluation of the world of work, and digital solutions have been at the center of these shifts, progressing digital transformation across the globe. The fourth industrial revolution has seen a dramatic increase in workplace efficiency. But as we move forward, will business leaders rise to the challenge and embrace these digital-enabled efficiencies while still maintaining a people-centric future?